I've been doing art for about 10 years now. Last 2.5, 3 years, I've been dealing with tin cans and metal cans and discarded metal, discarded TV parts, anything I can get my hands on that I can turn into something else. I have been feeding the homeless close to 3 years now. We just started handing out food, and we handed out 40 in 5 minutes, and there were 100 people in line. We just felt terrible that we couldn't feed everybody. Figured that with the same amount of money that we feed a few people, if I cooked it fresh myself, we could feed a lot more people for a lot less money. We started out feeding 12 people in the park. I found this discount food place that sells dented cans, and we bought a bunch of frozen dinners, and we took 40 of them, and it came out to be $40. And it was just little portions of frozen meals, and I'm like, oh, I can do better. So the next week I started to cook food, and there was more people in the park. But it was getting out of control. There was too many people, and we just couldn't afford 200 meals. The most we could afford is 100. We happened upon a bunch of old people standing in front of an open door in front of this old building. And we handed them some meals, and as soon as we did, the door opened, and 60 to 80 people, older people in their 50s and 60s, came out and took our food. And we were like, wow, what is this place? So the lady who opened the door said, it's a shelter for people that are 55 and older. We open up in the mornings, and they come on in, and sometimes we have a podiatrist, sometimes we have a dentist, sometimes the church comes and washes their feet and does manicures, and then they drop off clothes, and the girls all go in the back and get dresses, but we can't cook food here. So my wife and I decided from then on, every Saturday we'll go and we'll take them their hot meals. You know, it's people 60 years old homeless, or, you know, 60 years old on an $800 income, and the rent of their place is $700. So they come in there to get AC in the weekdays and get something to eat. I can't imagine being 55 and being on the streets of Phoenix. It's 112 degrees and it's 9 o'clock in the morning. Can you imagine that? My larger goal is to get a larger kitchen closer to the people and be able to feed them hot meals faster and more people is my end goal. The money that I get from selling my art goes to purchasing more canned foods to feed homeless people.